What is up, people? My name is Gnuntaflot and I'm back here today with another video. And I'm also back behind these boxes. Today, we are building a computer. Let's get started. Okay, that's better. I'm gonna go through the parts as I use them. That's the easiest. And if you want a parts list, that's down below. And we're just gonna start building. First, we need to lay down some ESD mat right on this table. There we go, now we're ready to start building. And I didn't mention this, but this computer is not for me, it's for a friend. So, we need to make it perfect, since it's not for me. Let's start with the motherboard, and the motherboard is an ASUS Prime Z390A. Just so you know, this is not a build guide. I won't be going through by step how to build a computer. If you want to do that, there's so much more better videos. This is just building. I need the IO shield. I need the M2 screw. I don't need this. I don't need these. I'm gonna build it right on top of here. For our CPU, we got the i7-9700K. Let's install the CPU, shall we? There we go, CPU is installed. Let's do SSD next. For the SSD, we have the Samsung 970 EVO Plus. 1 teraflops. Now we need the screw. And we install the standoff in the furthest away hole. Now plop in the SSD. Let's bring out the iFixit Pro Toolkit. A little hard to do with a microphone in your face. But nothing is impossible. Let's go memory, and we have the Corsair DDR for 16GB, 3200MHz speed. Plop, plop. Now I'm gonna get the case prepped, and I'll be right back. There's a box in the box. Why? We're supposed to fit a 360 rad in here, but it looks so small, so I'm figuring maybe we should remove this panel. This little bracket here that's underneath the fan, and it can go down there. I think that is what we need to do. Now the case is open. Internal layout, I'll show you a little bit closely, and then it's time to put in the motherboard. There we go, the motherboard is now installed. Luckily this case had pre-installed standoffs in the case, so I didn't have to screw every one of those in. And that's very nice. And now we are on to the fun stuff. I think we're gonna start with the radiator, because I'm least sure how we're gonna fit that. So we need to screw away this fan in front, pop out the front panel, fit the radiator, see which way you're gonna put it in, and then mount this fan in the top. Instead, before we do that, I need to present the cooler we're using. ASUS ROG Ruin 360 liquid CPU cooler. It's way too huge for this CPU, but if he wants to do some overclocking later on, this beast is gonna get the job done. It's pretty with the RGB, same brand as the motherboard, so easy to control everything. Fan curves, lighting, all of that good stuff. Thank you. For LGA 1151, you want to have these pushed all the way in. This specific cooler uses this fence, which is actually Noctua fence, which is the best fence on the market. So these are good quality shit. Is installed. I had to remove the hard drive cage completely to get it in, but that's fine. Nobody uses hard drives anyway unless you do film editing, but he is not gonna do that, so that's fine. You still have room for SSDs both on the front and the back, so you can put in plenty. The cooler is installed. Next is the power supply, and then we need to put back the fan. Put the fan in the top instead of in the front. We're gonna use that as intake as well, actually. For the power supply, we went with the RM850 from Corsair. I wanted it to have some specifications. I wanted it to be 80 plus gold at least, passive and modular. And this one fits the job nicely. Let's mount the power supply. There we go, we have finished almost everything. It's just the graphics card left, and I pulled the cable for the graphics card through the previous hard drive cage. And I think that's gonna be good. I'm gonna try, put it in, see how it looks. The EVGA 2080 Super. Super good graphics card, creme de la crop, best of the best, almost best of the best. One of the newest, bestest, greatest cards. It's good. Alright, everything is done. Let's see if this thing boots up, as it should. And we have a boot, yay! One drive, three keyboards, two mice, one hub, and a cooler. Alright then, everything is done. Computer works is fine. Now I'm just gonna load up Windows, do some updates, install some programs. But that was everything for this video. If you liked it, then please leave a like so I know what you think. And why don't you also head on down there, click that subscribe button, and maybe that little bell to never miss a video. Until the next video, have yourself a good day. Bye-bye.
Did I really just forget that melody?
No.
When I popped off, then your girl gave me just a little bit of la cha, baby, so cool.